Nowadays, everyone wants to look good and confident. And having a great physique is seen as a symbol of strength, elegance, power and dominance. That's the reason why many men and women are considering to join a gym to get the physique they desire. So in this episode of What the Science, we will be looking into the science behind bodybuilding and muscle growth. So without wasting much time, let's flex some brain muscles to understand how bodybuilding works and what you should avoid while building your muscles. Bodybuilding was developed in late 19th century and was promoted in England by a German, Eugene Sandow. Eugene allowed audiences to enjoy viewing his physique in muscle display performances. These performances became a huge hit with the audiences and thus resulted into the first bodybuilding contest held on September 14, 1901 called as the Great Competition, which was organized by Eugene Sandow himself. Nowadays, various competitions are held all over the world based on the same idea of Eugene Sandow. Thus, he was rightfully called the father of bodybuilding. Bodybuilding, which started as a fitness sport, now became the weekly activity of people who wanted to have a great physique. So even if you are a beginner or have been hitting the gym for years, you need to understand some basic aspects of bodybuilding so that you can maximize your gains and avoid injury. Muscle growth is also called as hypertrophy in technical terms. Hypertrophy is actually a response to the stress which we have evolved over time. Basically, the muscles are made up of muscle fiber which make up the muscle tissue. These cells are different from other cells of the body in a variety of ways. There are three types of muscle cells in our body: cardiac muscle, smooth muscle, and skeletal muscle. As far as bodybuilding is concerned, we will be talking about skeletal muscles throughout. Skeletal muscles are composed of thread-like myofibrils and sacromeres that forms the muscle fiber and are the basic units of contraction. There are 650 types of skeletal muscles in our body. The motor neurons are the ones which control your skeletal muscles. The motor neurons tell the skeletal muscles to contract and relax. The better you become at having those signals, the stronger you get. This is the reason why a powerlifter is able to lift heavy weight despite not looking very muscular. It is due to their ability to activate those motor neurons and contract their muscles better. Motor unit recruitment also helps us to explain why after practice, certain movements become easier to perform and most of the initial strength gains happen when you first start to lift the weights. This is the reason why you may see muscle growth during the initial few weeks of training, but as the time passes, you won't see any substantial growth in your muscles since now you can easily activate these muscles without stressing them. When we exercise, it causes the muscle fiber to tear slightly in what is called as a micro tear. This is actually a good thing as this is how the muscle will grow. In response to the muscle tearing, the body will use satellite cells to fix the tears, building them up more thicker each time to prevent future damage. This repair will require amino acids which body gets from protein in the system. The muscles that are repaired become thicker and they require greater load and more repetitions to be torn. And this is how and why we are able to increase the load that we work with. Muscle growth occurs whenever the rate of muscle protein synthesis is greater than the rate of muscle protein breakdown. This happens not when you are lifting weights, but when you are taking rest. So how do you add muscle to your muscle cells? This is where the satellite cells come in. When activated, they help to add more nuclei to the muscle cells and therefore contribute directly to the growth of muscle cells. Thus, activation of satellite cell is the difference between fast gainers and hard gainers. Now the main question arises, how do you activate these satellite cells to increase muscle growth? Well, the underlying principle of natural muscle growth is the ability to continually put more stress on the muscles. The simple way to do this is to lift progressively heavier weights, and this additional tension in the muscle causes changes in the chemistry of the muscle, allowing for growth factors such as activation of satellite cells. Hormones also play an important factor in muscle growth. Testosterone is the main hormone that most people think about when working out. Testosterone increases protein synthesis, inhibits protein breakdown, activates satellite cells, and stimulates growth hormone responses by increasing the presence of neurotransmitters at the damaged fiber site. But another hormone which is also vital in muscle growth is IGF, insulin growth factor. IGF regulates the amount of muscle mass growth by enhancing protein synthesis, enhancing glucose uptake, repartitioning the uptake of amino acids into skeletal muscles, and also activating satellite cells to increase the muscle growth. Muscles need rest to grow, as stated earlier. So you need to give adequate rest to your body to recover and grow strong. Nutrition is one of the most important factors which people overlook. If you are not providing necessary nutrition in order to build muscle, they won't grow, and the body will start using up reserves to compensate for the shortfall. The result, you will start losing muscles instead of gaining them. Micro tears are good for muscle growth, but overtraining will cause these tears to become severe and will result in serious injuries. So do not overtrain, it does not have any benefit. Also, do not rush to hit the heaviest weight as fast as possible. Muscle growth is a slow process and it takes time. Build your strength gradually and take your time to increase the weights. In addition to that, different people have different genetics, which plays an important role in muscle growth. Some people can gain muscles easily, while some find it hard to gain muscles. So one need to follow the workout regime best suited for their body to get the desired results. So that's it from this episode of What the Science. Please feel free to put down your comments and suggestions about this episode in the comment section below. Also, if you like what we are doing, then you can support us by clicking on the red subscribe button and the notification button to stay updated. And since you have watched this video so far, so please do hit the like button also. We are keeping a target of 100 likes on this video, so please do help us achieve this target. You can watch more videos from my channel by clicking on the videos appearing on your screen right now, or you can watch other playlists from my channel by clicking on the link above. Thank you for watching. See you soon with another video.